So, effectiveness of fiscal policy. Why the government adopts a fiscal policy? This is basically an aggregate demand management policy. Fiscal policy or monetary policy, both are imposed, both are the instruments in the hand of the public, the government, to increase the aggregate demand, to solve the problem of shortage of effective demand. So, today we will discuss under which conditions fiscal policies will be more effective. So, to discuss this, we have to consider the functioning of the fiscal policy, the mechanism, how fiscal policy boosts up the aggregate demand. So, let us consider the entire process once more. That if we consider there is a fiscal policy, that G will increase, or we consider the tax will fall. In both cases, if G increases, what we will see? That it will directly boost up the aggregate demand. Or if tax rate falls, first we will see the disposable income will increase. So if there is an increase in the disposable income, that will cause an increase in consumption, which is a part of aggregate demand, and YD will increase. So this is the first step. So next step, there will be interaction with the money market, because this increase in aggregate demand will always cause an increase in demand for money. So whenever there is a demand for money, the rate of interest mechanism will come to work. That means if we say that there is excess demand situation in money market, so consequently there will be excess supply situation in the bond market. So bond prices will fall and rate of interest will rise. So whenever rate of interest rises, so speculative demand for money will fall, and on the other hand, the private investment will fall. So there will be, to some extent, there will be decline in aggregate demand. So this entire mechanism will be continued unless we find that the money market is in equilibrium. So the effectiveness of fiscal policy depends on two things. Number one, how fast the demand for money responds towards the change in rate of interest. And second, how sensitive the private investment is to the change in rate of interest. So these two things determines the effectiveness of fiscal policy. So from these two things, first we can say here, number one, number one is what? If LR is more sensitive to rate of interest, that implies what? More effectiveness of fiscal policy. So I have come to the mathematics later. First, let us explain it with the help of logic. So what happens here? See, in this case, whenever there is excess demand for money market, in the mechanism, rate of interest will start to rise. So if speculative demand for money is highly sensitive to rate of interest, what will happen? A small increase in rate of interest will immediately recover the money market from excess demand situation. So that time the rate of interest will not rise much. A small increase in rate of interest, money market equilibrium will be restored. So, and why rate of interest is significant here? If there is a small interest increase in rate of interest, given the interest sensitivity of private investment, if small increase in rate of interest is there, there will be small volume of crowding out. But if we consider the opposite scenario, that speculative demand for money is highly insensitive to interest rate. So in that situation, what will happen? To restore the money market equilibrium, there should be a huge increase in rate of interest. So in that case, what will happen? Given the interest sensitivity of private investment, if the rate of interest will, there is a high increase in rate of interest, that will create a higher volume of crowding out. So higher volume, the volume of crowding out, lower will be the effectiveness of fiscal policy. So from here we can say that if speculative demand for money is highly sensitive to rate of interest, there will be higher will be the effectiveness of fiscal policy. That means effectiveness of fiscal policy is directly related to the interest sensitivity of speculative demand for money. First point. Second point. Point number two. Higher the interest sensitivity of private investment, that means fiscal policy is less effective. So that means what? The effectiveness of fiscal policy is inversely related to the interest sensitivity of private investment. So what is the logic behind that? If we consider that interest rate is highly sensitive to rate of interest, so a small increase in rate of interest will cause a huge crowding out. So there will be the fiscal effectiveness of fiscal policy will be dampened by the crowding out effect. So, and the opposite, that if we think the opposite, if the interest rate is less sensitive to rate of interest, then a huge increase in rate of interest, but there will be a small decline in private investment. So we can say higher the interest sensitivity of private investment, higher will be the crowding out effect and lower will be the effectiveness of fiscal policy. So now we will prove our statement with the help of diagrams. So first let us consider two cases. In both cases the private interest sensitivity of private investment is same. That means the slope of IS curve is same in both cases. So let us consider it. So in both cases, slope of IS curves are same. Now we consider here the speculative demand for money is very less sensitive to rate of interest, this case. And in lower diagram, we consider that speculative demand for money is highly sensitive to rate of interest. Now, in both cases, we take the same volume of increase in public investment. So that means the horizontal distance between two IS curves are same. So, in case 1, this is case 1 and this is case 2. So, in case 1 and case 2, we think that this is the volume of fiscal policy. We consider it delta G. Now, here also Y0, Y dash. Here also Y0, Y dash. So Y0, Y dash indicates the, this is the expansionary fiscal policy. So now what will happen here? If we consider this point F dash. So this is E0, this is also E0. So we start with the same rate of interest, R0Y0, R0Y0. So by the money market, what do we see? We see in both cases, F indicates the point, F and F dash are the points at which commodity market is in equilibrium, but money market is not in equilibrium, disequilibrium. And in both cases, the points are below the LM curve. That means this is excess demand situation for money. And we know that rate of interest will rise. So in this case, what we see? We keep steeper LM curve means rate of speculative demand for money is less sensitive to the rate of interest. So that's why here we need a higher. There is, in this case, what we see R0, R1. This is the new equilibrium rate of interest R1, and the output level will finally increase to OY0 to OY1. Why? Because there is high increase in rate of interest, so there is high volume of, so this is the volume of crowding out. Now let us consider case 2. So here also we consider the excess demand situation in the money market, so rate of interest will rise. But we see that LM curve is flatter. So we see here LM curve is so in this case LM curve is flatter. That means speculative demand for money is highly sensitive to rate of interest. So just there will be a small increase in rate of interest to restore the money market equilibrium. So it is R0 to R1 dash, and output level will increase from Y0 to Y1 dash. So if you compare between the final increase in output, here Y0 to Y1, here Y0 to Y1 dash. And the main cause is here, what is the main reason behind this difference? The only thing that plays the major role for the difference between these two diagrams is that here speculative demand for money is highly interest insensitive. That's why there is a higher increase in rate of interest. There is a lower increase in rate of interest. In this case, this is the due to high increase in rate of interest. In both cases, what we see? Interest sensitivity of private investment is same in both cases. That's why these two IS curves are parallel to each other. But in this case, so higher rate of interest change, higher volume of crowding out. In this case, there is lower volume of crowding out. So from here, we can conclude that the higher the interest sensitivity of speculative demand for money, higher will be the effectiveness of fiscal policy. In simple words, for a flatter LM curve, fiscal policy will be more effective. For a steeper LM curve, fiscal policy will be less effective. Now we will prove that the effectiveness of fiscal policy is inversely related to the interest sensitivity of private investment. So now in both cases we will consider the same interest. So in both cases we will consider that the LM curves are parallel to each other. That means in both cases interest sensitivity of speculative demand for money same. Now here we consider steeper IS curve. And here we consider a flatter IS curve. Now, so this is IS, this is also IS. This is LM, this is LM. In horizontal axis, we are measuring Y and in vertical axis we are measuring rate of interest r. So this is E0 and here is also E0. So we start with the same level of output in both cases. Now let us consider an expansionary fiscal policy. So there will be parallel shift of the IS curve. Here I1, S1, and here also consider the same shift of IS curve. So here I'll give it. So this is I dash, S dash. So Y0, Y dash in both cases will indicate the volume of expansionary fiscal policy. So in both cases we will see that this is the point and this is the point. We can give it F and F dash. F and F dash indicate excess demand for money. So in both cases what we will see, rate of interest will increase from R0 to R1. So here also it is increasing from R0 to R1. But in this case, in case 1, so this will increase from Y0 to Y1. This is the volume of crowding out effect. And in this case, what we will see? We will see that there is the higher volume of crowding out effect. So this is the effectiveness of fiscal policy. Here this is the effectiveness of fiscal policy. So in both cases, rate of interest rises by the same extent due to money market mechanism. But here in the case 1, there is less effect on private investment because we are finding here, we find here the IS curve is steeper. IS curve steeper means investment is less sensitive to rate of interest. Here the IS curve is flatter. That means investment is more sensitive to rate of interest. So in this case, in case 1, there will be lower volume of crowding out effect. In case 2, there will be the higher volume of crowding out effect for the same increase in rate of interest. So that means what? That means if in both cases the interest sensitivity of speculative demand for money same, that means we are considering the parallel LM curves. The slope of both LM curves are same. But here we consider highly interest in the private investment is less interest sensitive, private investment is more interest sensitive. So here will be for the same increase in rate of interest, in case 1 there will be less crowding out effect, hence fiscal policy will be more effective here, and in this case fiscal policy will be less effective here. So from the diagram we can say steeper the IS curve, higher will be the effectiveness of fiscal policy. And flatter the IS curve, lower will be the effectiveness of fiscal policy. Steeper the IS curve, less volume of crowding out. Flatter the IS curve, more volume of crowding out. So we can conclude that if LM curve is steeper, fiscal policy will be less effective. Flatter the IS curve, fiscal policy will be less effective. Flatter LM curve, fiscal policy will be more effective. Steeper IS curve, fiscal policy will be more effective.